friends, and welcome to my third journal flip through. So we'll be looking through this journal today. If you haven't already watched my other two flip throughs, then you should definitely watch those after. I'm basically just going to be talking you through my journal, and then afterwards we'll be setting up the new one. So that's really exciting. So yeah, I hope you enjoy and get some inspiration. And if you do enjoy it, make sure to subscribe. So without further ado, let's just get started. Hello friends, and welcome to my third journal flip through. Okay, so I'm going to be using the same leather cover for my next journal and all of those after this flip through. And then it means I get to decorate a new one. So we'll start with the sticker on the front, and this is a waterproof vinyl sticker from Thanks You. It was from one of her previous Patreon rewards. So on this first page, we have our cover page. Because I started it throughout the year, I just put the little date stamp there, which says the 10th of March. So I'd say I filled it up pretty quickly, and then I just decorated using some of this really pretty like pansy pet tape that I had, and went with like a spring purpley theme. For this one, I didn't put any like big sticker on the inside, but on the next one I do have a big sticker that I plan on sticking on the front. This is just a daily spread, and I used some of the new Marigona Sulli art stickers. This is like two spreads in one, but I made them so that they were pretty cohesive. So I made an Easter cake, and I really wanted to document the fact that I did any baking. And I had this really pretty new washi tape as well that I wanted to use, that one of my pen pals had sent me. And then this was just about a day of gardening, so I felt like a garden theme would be pretty good. And then this sticker here is from my pen pal as well, Cottage Corsu. So she sent me a lot of her handmade stickers, which are in a lot of these spreads. This next spread is the first reading spread for this journal insert. And I have been recording since this spread all of my reading journal setups. Because I don't have a reading journal, I just keep them all in here, so you will see in the future all of those kind of edited into one. So it will be like a reading journal video, just without the reading journal, if that makes sense. So yeah, I read Hellbent and I really liked it. I definitely preferred it to the first one. And again, use some more of the same stickers. You'll see a lot of these stickers throughout my journal. And then just some like dark academia things. So this next spread was about my best friend's hen do, which I know a lot of people call it a bachelorette party. So I added some Polaroids because we went pottery painting, and then we also went and got pizza. So I really wanted to remember this and document, because it was the first one of my friends getting married, so it was quite an important thing to remember. And then this is just from the same trip. I scanned the pictures from the photo booth, and then I basically put them all into a collage for the insects. And these little stickers you'll see a lot in my journal. One of my pen pals makes and sends me them. She's called Petal Pages on Instagram. So yeah, I went with kind of a red theme because that was kind of like what the pizza place was themed. And then I also wanted to journal about me and my best friend because we just booked a summer holiday. So I want to document that, and we made lots of friendship bracelets as well, which was pretty cute. So yeah, I was just really wanting to add that in there. This you might have already seen if you watch my travel journal with me videos, because this one was all about a trip, and there's quite a few spreads on this. It was just from about one day, kind of like a walk, and it was basically like 2 days away, kind of like a weekend, but I just kind of squished it all into one. So I added some different instaxes, and then I tried out a new way of decorating, so doing a bit more like free flowing rather than just all around the edges. And I really liked how it turned out, because the writing more fits around all the other stuff rather than creating a border and then having all my writing in the middle. And then I also added the map as well, that we went the route that we took, so I'm definitely going to keep doing that whenever I document a walk. So yeah, I really like these spreads. I think that they're really cute. And if you want to see that, then you can see the footage from my trip too, because I always include that in all of my travel journal with me's. It always starts with a little mini vlog of what I've been up to, so it kind of makes sense when I'm talking about it. Then I met one of my pen pals, Lucy. It's not the first time we've met quite a few times, and I got to meet her cats, which was really exciting. So I wanted to do a spread about that, and I added the receipt from our lunch out. And then again, this is another half of a spread, but I wanted to make it cohesive, and I used a lot of like purple stationery because I wanted to talk about how we'd gone on a little walk to the Bluebell Woods, but the bluebells weren't there, so, but I see more bluebells in the future, spoiler alert. Here is another reading spread. I feel like maybe I shouldn't show you this if you're gonna see me make this in an upcoming video, but I will. So yeah, I won't go into too much detail about that because I'll be talking about it in my reading video, but I really like this book. And then I also read the second one pretty much straight after, so I had to obviously include that too. And I really liked adding these book page covers to the spread, so I might do that in the future. The next spread is all about a gardening day that I had, and Ralph was joining me in the garden, so I just wanted to add some photos. And then this was some really cute washi that I got that I felt like would go really well with this theme. And this is a Polaroid cover that I got for my birthday, and I got a little pack of them, and they're all such cute designs and they just stick right on. So I feel like that's a really good way if you want to get some like fancy Polaroid frames, but sometimes the pattern ones are like way more expensive. Or theoretically, you could literally just print out a picture on A4 paper, stick it in your journal, and then just stick that on top, as long as obviously it's the right size. And then that way you can have like mini Polaroids in your journal without having to actually print them out. This was all about my birthday, even though it's not actually on my birthday, but this is what I did for my birthday. I went and visited this vintage bookshop, so I wanted to use a lot of vintage stationery and add a little Polaroid in there too. And yeah, I think this looks really cute. Again, there's another travel journal video on my YouTube about it. And yeah, I like the dark academia look. This was when we did visit another forest, which happened to be filled with bluebells, not planned, but it was just like so amazing. So I had to make a spread as soon as I got home all about it. You'll notice that I journal a lot about my walks. And when I actually started journaling, which you haven't even seen that journal on my channel, so I might need to show you in the future, I had like a walking journal, and I would journal about whenever I went for a walk, about the route. And I have one of those little thermal printers, so I'd stick pictures in. Obviously that you couldn't really see what was going on those photos, but it was really cute, so I might show you actually in another video. This was actually about my birthday, so I ripped this from the envelope that my partner got me because my cat's called Ralph, so I wanted to put that in because I thought it was cute. And then I also stuck in one of the like gift tag labels that my mum added in my gift, and I just thought it was really cute to add like little messages from people. It's a good way to just preserve those memories forever. So this next spread was all about a walk that I went on. And I'm just covering my face because otherwise my camera like focuses like crazy on the face and then everything just gets blurred out. So you'll notice that there's a lot of these quote stickers in my journal too. They are from my Patreon rewards, so I've been really enjoying using those in my journals. And this spread looks a little bit autumnal, but the day that we went for this walk, it was actually raining a lot, so I feel like I'm allowed to do an autumnal spread in my spring-ish journal. Well, that's okay. And I really like how this one came out. I just added all the leftover stickers that I didn't use on my travel journal spread from the hike. And then this is where I start to go a bit crazy with the Taylor Swift spreads, because obviously I'm a Swiftie and the Tortured Poets Department came out, so I wanted to make some spreads themed around it, because I have made other spreads in my journals about like Taylor Swift albums, And yeah, this one was really fun to make. I was actually really surprised with how much stationery I actually had. So this is the first one. I just talked about my thoughts on the album, and then the other ones are more like art slash collage ones. So I just added some of my favorite quotes or my favorite songs, and then just decorated it around this like academia theme, because obviously her album's themed around poetry and manuscripts and all that fun stuff. So it was a really great one to journal about, and I think this might be my favorite spread that I did out of them all. Or maybe this one is, I don't know. I really like these two. And I really like how I like distressed the paper, so it looks like it's kind of been set on fire. And this is a washi tape, and I just think it's so cute, these film ones, and I always forget that I have them. So yeah, they worked really well with the theme. This was a spread all about the wedding of the hen do that you saw earlier. So I wanted to add a photo of me at the wedding, and I had this really pretty like dress. It kind of reminded me of Cinderella, and the whole wedding was in like a big botanical gardens. So I added these like stickers that were kind of themed around like secret garden plants, and yeah, they just went well with the theme. And then this was the little like favor thing that was on the table, but it was full of seeds, so I also added that because it has the name and the date. And I am probably going to do some more journaling about this wedding when the pictures come out, because I want to add some photos of like us and the bride and groom too. Sorry, Ralph has just appeared. Talking of Ralph, this next spread is all about moon journaling, which I mentioned in my last video briefly, so I won't go into too much detail about it. But yeah, I started doing that in this journal, and I think I'm going to continue to do it. I've decided that I'm only doing 2 spreads a month. I know that you can obviously dive in a lot deeper and do them more often, but I'm just going to commit to 2 a month. I feel like it's not too scary, but it's also good for me to reflect during those times. So yeah, I've just covered my writing up because obviously it's quite personal. But I really like this one. I use this like Tea Witch sticker sheet. And yeah, it just looks really cute. It's also fun because it means that I can try and create some more like celestial themes, because they're not really things that I particularly do that often, but I do really enjoy making them. This next one is just to document a nice day that I had at the weekend. So I used these like little text stickers, and then again, just more Marigona Sooley art stuff. This is what I mean by a lot of the time I write in the middle. First I decorate around the edge, and then I do my writing in the space in the middle. But it's been nice to experiment with some different compositions. This next spread is one that I did in my finishing my journal video, and it's maybe one of my favorites, which I didn't expect it to be. But again, I've gone for that like composition where I'm just breaking up the writing a little bit, to be honest. And I added in this photo of Ralph just sunbathing in the garden, and he looks so cute. You can't really see it on the actual photo because the Polaroid hasn't printed very well. But yeah, he just looks really cute, and it's just fun to document what he's up to because he has like really specific routines. So it's nice to document what he's doing at that time. He like goes through phases of doing stuff, and he's very naughty, I would like to point out as well, as you just witnessed. So this next page was to have a collection, a bit like an art gallery, of all the stamps that people have sent me. It's not all of them, but I want to like fill a spread at a time rather than like have to keep going back and then like sticking more on. So I'm now hoarding more stamps until I have enough to make another spread, probably in my next insert, if I get enough in time. And yeah, I just think this is a really cute way to just document things coming into your mailbox and where they've come from. So we've got lots of different countries in here. Some are from pen pals, some are from people that have sent letters to my PO box. So you might notice one in here that you've sent. But yeah, I do really like this spread. I think it turned out really cute and way more effective than I expected it to. This was another general daily spread, just talking about my garden, and I am going to do a lot more spreads about my garden in the future, but this one was just to document how everything is flowering so nicely at the moment, and just an excuse to do like a cute botanical spread as well. Sometimes I like to just write little notes on memos like this rather than doing like a whole written bit. And this is the other half of my moon journaling. So you start, well, I'm gonna start with the new moon, and then near the end of the month I will reflect on my intentions. So this is just me talking about if I have achieved what I set out to, how I'm doing, what can I change. So yeah, it's been really fun to try out that new style of journaling as well. Here we have a spread all about Bridgerton, because I have already finished part one twice. So I finished it obviously like by just watching it, and then I also drew a load of stickers for Bridgerton theme. So I also rewatched it when I was doing that. And I just printed out some photos from my computer and then just decorated them again. I don't do this about everything that I watch, but I like to do it about certain favorite shows. This next one was just more daily journaling. I saw some family and went for another walk, and I had this cute like gingham, is it gingham? No, it's tartan paper. And I just did like a red and green like kind of strawberry theme, although I didn't have that much strawberry stationery. This spread was surprisingly is maybe one of my favorites too, and I actually made this one yesterday as I'm filming this, because I went for a walk to photograph my journal and some pen pal envelopes, and the forest was just looking amazing basically. So I wanted to do a spread about it, but I wanted to do something a little bit different to like my other ones that where I've talked about the forest. So I ended up doing some like gouache painting on some watercolor paper, and then I just cut them out because I haven't tried to paint on this paper, but I feel like it would probably go through. It is fountain pen friendly, but yeah, I don't think it would last gouache, and I don't really want to risk it. So I just felt like this was better, and it kind of creates more of like a textured look. And I don't mind like buffing out my journal when it's near the end of it, because it doesn't really matter if it gets too big then. So yeah, I really like this one. I recently got sent a bunch of cherry blossom themed stationery from one of my pen pals, and I basically just wanted to put it all into a spread, but I wasn't particularly sure what I wanted to create. So I had like a spring favourites where I just talked about what I was reading, watching, what I've been obsessed with. So it literally says also being obsessed with my Crocs at the moment, which is a true story. So I've also been talking about the music I've been listening to, the book that I'm currently reading. So I have started A Court of Thorns and Roses, finally. So yeah, that will be the next reading spread you'll see in the future. And this sticker is from Mochi Bujo. I think it's from one of her Patreon ones, I'm not sure, but my pen pal sent it me, so I assume she is one of her patrons. And then this is the final spread of the journal, and I decided to add in my Receiptify into it just from like the last month, just kind of like to finish it off. And if you don't know what Receiptify is, it's basically a website that you log into with your Spotify, and it will just like give you this really cute like receipt of all your favorite songs, things that you've been listening to. So a lot of it is Taylor Swift. Well, it's pretty much all Taylor Swift, apart from one, which is Espresso by Sabrina Carpenter, because this is essentially all I have been listening to since the album came out. So yeah, I felt like it was just fun to add that in so that future me can see what I was listening to at this time of the year. And I just did a little blue theme because I don't really have many blue themes in this insert. And yeah, that is the flip through all finished. So that means now we get to do the fun bit and decorate my new journal. Okay, so before we start to decorate the new insert, I need to take out all of these ones and then add in my new insert. I guess I'm just gonna keep all of my used ones on my shelf until I figure out a way to obviously store them. So the first one that I used, this is my first ever one. I didn't end up decorating the front, so that is something that I've definitely started doing. But yeah, the full flip through of this one is on my YouTube channel. And then this one I did put a sticker on, and again there is another flip through of this one on my channel. So I now have these three, which can just sit nicely on my shelf and stay with me for the rest of my life. I don't really know why I have this, because I honestly don't ever use it. Like, this stationery has been in here since I first started my journal and I've literally never used it. And it's getting pretty battered with the ramp as well. But I guess I'll just keep it in there until it doesn't survive anymore. So I'll now add in my new, in fact, no, I need to decorate it first. It's very important. I recently bought loads of like big stickers from Marigona City Art, and this is where I store all of my stickers from her, because I have a lot. So there are some big stickers from her new update that I wanted to use, because they are spring themed, but I'm going to be using them as like a summer theme. And because they go together, I felt like it'd be really good to have them on the front cover of the journal and then have this on the inside. So this is what the stickers look like. So yeah, as I said, this one will definitely be like my summer insert. And for the front, I don't really decorate. I literally just stick on the sticker. So that's the front one decorated. That one's pretty simple. And then obviously I'll start to decorate the inside, but I did also decide to put on some extra stickers this time, not on the front. These are from like previous Patreon rewards, because I just have like a million of these stickers that I just need to start using. So I just picked a couple of spring ones, and then I'm gonna put one on the back and one on the like first inside. So this page will be obviously very decorated, but I'm just seeing which one will go best with this sticker. I feel like maybe the purple one, because then I can use that one on the back. And this sticker here is from the same artist that created this one. I think it might have even been from the same Patreon rewards month, I don't know. And then this is from Megan Wang Art. I've been a patron of hers for a very long time, so I have a lot of her stickers. And they're usually just of like silly things, but they're cute. So yeah, these little flower guys can go on the back of my journal. And then we've got this big sticker on the front. So I guess now we get to decorate this page, which is the fun bit. First of all, I started by just getting a bunch of pink and green stationery, because obviously that's the colour theme of the big sticker, so I wanted to continue that throughout the spread. And I felt like those colours always remind me of spring, summer, so I felt like it'd be a good transition into my summer journal. I also found these little memos that I already had, which are slightly green, and I just thought they were really cute just to layer behind the main sticker. Sometimes it's hard to decorate the first page in a spread because it can feel like a lot of pressure, because it's usually like an important spread for the journal and obviously the first one you'll usually see. So sometimes I find it really difficult, but this time it was actually quite easy and I just kind of did everything around the main sticker and then just kind of covered it with all the different stickers that I had. I also used this Freckles Tea stamp a bunch of times just to make it seem like there were like petals and flowers flowing all over the page in a way. You might have seen from my last journal that I also added some pansies on the front of that one, but that one was like a purple lilac theme. And I found these little pastel pink pansies and I felt like I wanted to use them again because they just felt like they would go really cute with the four-leaf clover stickers. And they're a pretty good size as well, just to dot around the spread and fill in any little gaps. I also added these little stickers that I had cut out from a little sticker sheet, and they also have a holographic like lining around the edge, so they make a really nice effect too. I do wish that they would just, you could just pull them off though, because sometimes cutting them out is a bit of a pain. So that is the first spread all finished in my new journal, which is really exciting. It means that I can start decorating inside. I've already got a few spreads in mind that I want to create. So let me know what you think of the finished journal setup and if you like the spring summer vibe that I went for. So I really hope that you enjoyed watching this journal flip through. It was really fun to share it with you. And if you did enjoy, then please make sure to like and subscribe and come and join me on my YouTube channel to see more journal flip throughs, lots of travel journal with me's, pen pal with me's, all crafty stuff. So hopefully you'll be able to join and I'll see you next time. Bye.